Welcome to the FBCJ press briefing. National and regional science academies of the G7 and other countries meet annually at G-Science Academies meeting to develop joint statements of policy recommendations to be delivered to the leaders of each country. The joint statements developed at the G-Science Academies meeting held in February this year, hosted by Science Council of Japan, was delivered on April 19th to Prime Minister Abe, the chair of the G7 Iseshima Summit. We invited today Dr. Takashi Onishi, President of Science and Council of Japan, and Dr. Keisuke Hanaki, its Vice President, who directly handed over the recommendations to Prime Minister Abe, to speak about the statements. I kindly ask you to turn your mobile phones into the silent mode. Dr. Onishi, please.
Well, thank you for the opportunity to speak today at the Foreign Press Center on the G-Science Academy meeting held in Tokyo in February and the joint statement handed to political leaders of G7 countries in April. My name is Takashi Onishi, President of Science Council of Japan, and today Professor Hanaki, Vice President of Science Council of Japan, and myself will introduce what we discussed and what joint statements finally we made. First of all, I'd like to introduce a brief history of the G-Science Academy meetings. G-Science Academy meetings has been held every year since 2005 in the country where the G Summit is held. The purpose of these meetings is to request political leaders to reflect important issues from science and technology point of view into their discussion of the summit, which is done after the G-Science Academy meetings. This year, that will be at the end of May, Iseshima, Japan, as you may know. For example, we had the G-Science Academy meeting in Berlin, Germany, last year, because G7 summit was held in Germany. These slides show that the themes of G-Science meetings and the countries where the G summits were held. This slide and the next one. In the past, Science Council of Japan hosted G-Science Academy meeting once in 2008, when G8 summit at the moment was held in Hokkaido. Since then, we had the G-Science Academy meeting this year for the first time in 10 years. In addition, if you look at the themes taken up, you may realize that the G-Science Academy meeting discussed important subjects which together scientists and the political leaders should tackle with, such as global environmental issues, water resources, infection diseases, energy, and so on. One of the subjects we discussed this year is disaster risk reduction. This was taken in Washington, too, in year of 2012, after Great East Japan earthquake and the tsunami in 2011. Therefore, disaster risk reduction is one of the subjects which the world academies recognize should be discussed in the G7 summit. We had the G-Science meeting this year on 18th and 19th February, on top of G7 countries, Canada, France, Germany, Italy, UK, and USA, we, as the host academy, invited the representatives of science academies from Korea, Indonesia, India, Turkey, South Africa, Brazil, and African Academy of Sciences. You may find the names of participating academies in this slide. And then we are going into the contents of what we have discussed. Please, Hanaki-sensei.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Onishi. My name is Keisuke Hanaki. I'm a vice president in charge of international affairs in Science Council of Japan. And I would like to introduce you the major output of this G-Science meeting. I summarized the typical output we think important. We organized or we hosted this G7 G-Science meeting, and the time date was February 18th, 19, and the venue was Mita Conference Hall, in Japanese, Mita Kaigisho, which is a very nice conference facility in Tokyo. And after we discussed within Science Council of Japan, we determined three themes. Number one is brain science, the second is disaster resilience, the third is future scientist. And the finally, we obtained output of three statements of which copy you have, this one. There are three sets. And then this copy, or this statement are for G7 governments and the G7 summit. And after our meeting in February, we continued the discussion, and finally, we got final version in early April. And in each country, we handed over to the top of each government. I have here in highlights of the meeting, in the opening ceremony and the reception, we got addressed by Minister for Science and Technology Policy, who is Ms. Shimajiri, and she participated in our conference. And she showed much interest on that. And she will be chairing the Science Minister's meeting in Tsukuba next month. And then we had a follow-up session of G-Science 2015 last year, which was held in Germany. And I have another slide to explain on that. And after this follow-up session, we had a general introduction of three themes, and everybody has outlined of what is a major point of discuss in this general introduction. And then after that, we went to the very detailed discussion on statement, line by line. And because we have a various academy, and there are different opinions, but there are also common opinion. And we had a lot of discussion on the three themes. Follow-up session is like that. In 2015, German Academy of Science Leopold Diener hosted G-Science 2015 meeting with three themes. The first is infectious disease and antimicrobial resistance. The second is neglected tropical disease. And the third is future of the ocean. And after this G-Science meeting in Germany, these topics were discussed in summit also. And then there were have been a lot of advance or development in each of the countries. So all of the G7 countries have seen progress, and we had a summary session on that. Okay, now I would like to go into the detail of three themes. As I said, number one is brain science, and medical science people and also engineer met together and discussed about brain science. The title of the statement is Understanding, Predicting, and Developing Global Brain Resources. We use the word brain resources. And the proposal were, there are four proposals. The first is support fundamental research with international collaboration. Many countries spend much budget for much power of science to develop brain science, but we need international collaboration, obviously. The second is establish global program for the diagnosis, prevention, and treatment of brain disorders. Many countries are suffering from such brain disorders, right? And especially in many countries, there are more and more senior people, and also young people also have suffered such disorder. So how to utilize knowledge to such disease control is important. The number three is promote theoretical modeling of the brain and the development of brain-based artificial intelligence, so-called AI. Artificial intelligence is in the field of engineering or science, but brain science knowledge can be applied to develop AI. The fourth is integrate neuroscience with the social and the behavioral sciences to improve education and life management as essential components of a brain-aware society. In fact, the Science Council of Japan consists of social science and humanity and life science and engineering science. And of course, we think social science is important for our world. And this message shows that we should utilize knowledge in brain science into social science. The second statement was on disaster resilience. Strengthening disaster resilience is essential to sustainable development. As you know, Kumamoto earthquake is still going on, but that kind of issue are common to almost all countries. And there are six proposals. The one is develop metrics and indicators for evaluating exposure, vulnerability, and resilience. Various different types of disasters are happening in various different countries, but we have no common metrics. Right? In each country, they said, okay, we had such damage. But in order to accumulate knowledge, we have to develop metrics and indicators which are supposed to be common throughout the countries. The second is advance science and technical knowledge and improve assessment of disaster risk, including building relevant data infrastructure. All countries should collaborate together to develop and increase resilience. For that purpose, we need a data infrastructure. We need huge data. And the third is develop innovative engineering for disaster prevention and raise political and public awareness. We need technology also, and we are supposed to apply engineering for disaster prevention. And the fourth is strengthen inter- and transdisciplinary collaborative efforts to accelerate our transformation to a sustainable world. It's a little bit conceptual one. Everybody agreed that we are going to sustainable world, but for this purpose, we need to work with society, or we have to work throughout the different disciplines of science. We use the word of interdisciplinary when we talk about collaboration among different fields of science, and we use the word of transdisciplinary when we work society and also sciences. So we need such very interactive activity more and more. The fourth is engage the investor community using money, but actually using money for disaster prevention is, of course, important for disaster prevention, and it is also important for economic development as well. The number six is initiate a forum for information sharing with the private sector and relevant stakeholders to provide practical solution. Wide variety of fields of science are involved, and we have to initiate a forum for information sharing, and especially private sector and public sector partnership is important. So these are essence of the second statement. Third statement has eight proposals. This is the first page. Nurturing future scientists. Developing future scientists is obviously important for all countries or for world. And our society depends on the development of new scientists. And there are many problems we have in both in developed and developing country. The first proposal is further promotion of science education for necessary capacities. Science education is necessary for child or middle school students and high school students and university students and graduate school students and also all people who are working for a company or who are working for society. In each level, we need that one. The second is supporting young scientists for development of career in broader sectors. How to develop career of young scientists are really big issue in Japan and also in many countries as well. And scientists, we are scientists, always says that, okay, companies should take more scientists. But not only that, we try to develop the capacity of science. Scientists, young scientists should understand economics and politics and social system to increase their career. The third is implementation of scientist assessment based on quality and diverse activity. Very typical evaluation done in many universities, in many countries, is like that. Okay, I had 100 publications paper, and you have only 50 publications, and I am superior to you. But that is not good. That is also one indicator. But scientists are supposed to work more and more for society or for education. And working with society or education don't make research paper usually. So we should have more diverse, more comprehensive evaluation method. The fourth is prioritizing science communication to the public and the children. Science communication to society is important, and everybody understands in general. But we should pay more effort in science communication to public and children because they are supposed to support scientists. Number five is training scientists for science advice to policy. When we go to the academy meeting, you know, in many academies, there are always discussions on how scientists give advice to society or politicians. But to give advice, we have to train scientists to how to interpret your academic result to society. That is important. Number six is improving working conditions of women and minority group for career development. That is really big issue in Japan, especially for women scientists. Of course, we try to promote women scientists, but practically they have a difficulty in having baby. Usually, baby was born when young scientist was in the age of 35 or 40. And such age of 35 or 40 is quite important for researcher to be further development. So how to support such system is important. And depending on the academy, such minority group is also important. Minority group in terms of race or handicap, right? Such a minority group. Developing science capacity and mutual mobility by collaboration of developed and developing countries. In G Science meeting, we invited people from developing countries. And some of the situation is common, but there are many different situations. In developing countries, there are not many places for young scientists to work. Therefore, so-called brain drain still continue. Well, they go to a university in, say, Japan or US, Europe, and they don't go back. So to develop science capacity, we need collaboration between developed and developing countries through exchange program or scholarship program. Number eight is access to information, ensuring access to academic literature and information and opportunity for of publication of research result. Apparently, it looks simple, but the problem is the budget of access for information. Actually, nowadays, going to getting access for academic literature needs budget. In university, it happened also in Japan, many universities spent much money for getting information. And that is quite serious in developing countries. So we have to improve such situation. Okay, these are the summary of three statements. And towards the summit, we handed over three joint statements to Prime Minister Abe, accompanied by Shimajiri, Minister of State of, for Science and Technology Policy, on April 19. This is a schedule from now on. Main summit will be held in May 26 to 27 in Iseshima. But in addition to that, we are going to have education ministers meeting on May 14, 15 in Okayama. And at almost same timing, science and technology ministers meeting in Tsukuba, May 15 and 17. And then after main summit, health ministers meeting will be held in September in Kobe. And we really hope that our statement will be discussed in main summit, as well as this summit, these ministers meeting, which are more specialized for each of the topic. I think this is the end of our presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Onishi and Dr. Hanaki. Now, I would like to open the floor for questions. Not only the foreign press, but also I would like to open the entire floor for the questions. If you have a question, please raise your hand, and if designated, please use the microphone and state your name and affiliation before asking a question. Yes, Mr. Kakspitzer. Kakspitzer-san.
Microphone, please.
Hi, thank you. I'm Kirk Spitzer. I work for the newspaper USA Today. First of all, gentlemen, thank you very much. It's quite interesting. You mentioned the G7, so I guess I'll start with that. Are you looking for anything specific to come out of G7? And if so, and also you've outlined quite an agenda here. If there was one single thing that you would like to come out of G7, what would that be?
Well, a little bit difficult question. So we handed our joint statement to our prime minister, and of course, the Japan is the host country for this year G7 meeting. Therefore, the prime minister's office now thinking about what are the suitable subject for discussion in the G7 countries. And still, the agenda are not open. So we don't know what agenda they are going to discuss in G7 meeting. However, when we met Prime Minister Abe, he mentioned many things related to our three subjects. He stressed that those three subjects are very much important for the world leaders as well. So therefore, some of the subjects are not taken up as a main subject of the discussion in G7 meetings, but all of those subjects are somehow related to the main point of their discussions. So I hope that some of the comments are very much related to our joint statement. So that's our hope right now.
May I add a little different aspect? We invited people from developing country. Of course, they will not directly participate in G7 meeting. But we hope that this statement will be utilized in each of the developing country in other occasion. And because G7 meeting will discuss on developing country issue, in terms of collaboration with developing country. So we believe that G7 or a summit will be direct place to be, we hope to be utilized. But we think that other occasion is also important. And by issuing this kind of statement, we really hope that it will be utilized in various occasion. And another addition is about the topic on health. Health is always a big issue in this G-Science meeting, and it is also a big issue in the G7. And last year, German Academy of Science Leopoldina had two topics, infectious disease and neglected tropical disease. Maybe this topic will be discussed in G7 this year, because as you know, such infectious disease is always a big issue. But we think that in addition to such infectious disease, we would like to input another issue, that is brain science.
Any other questions? Yes, Kirk Spitzer-san.
Thank you. You mentioned budget issues earlier. Are G7 countries spending enough money on basic science, and is Japan spending enough money on basic science? And if not, how much should they be?
Mm. Oh, well, that's another very much important and difficult question to answer. As you may know, according to the UNESCO statistics, the Japanese government investment for the science and technology is not enough as compared with its GDP. So it's almost the bottom of the lineup of all the OECD countries. So therefore, the other countries invested the money for the science and technology policies at the bigger ratio than Japan has. So therefore, we have to make an effort, and we have to request our government to strengthen their effort to invest more money for the science and technology policies. But of course, this joint statement is, of course, different from that line. So that the same, the issuing these kind of joint statement, we, including the Science Council of Japan, doing many things to request the our government to make more effort to strengthen the science and technology power in this country. So I think that's a very much important subject right now in Japan.
May I add some? I think every academy think that the budget for science is not enough, right? However, if we issue such statement in G7 country, well, that's not a very good topic for G7, because just we claim, you know, giving money. That is not very good. Therefore, we think that we should have specific topic on which each government or academy collaborate to solve the problem. Therefore, we think that the budget issue will be claimed in another occasion.
Well, can we talk about risk reduction? How much more money should be spent on risk reduction? That's a very important issue. As you mentioned, the Kumamoto earthquake has just happened. We're still not completely recovered from that. So how much money should we be spending on risk reduction? How much more than we're spending now? I mean, it all comes down to money, doesn't it?
In terms of the risk reduction issue, the situation is different from country to country. So the Japan is one of the most vulnerable country to natural disaster risk. Mm-hmm. However, some of the European countries are safer than Japan in terms of the natural disaster risk. So therefore, the money those countries spend for risk reduction issue is smaller than we have to spend, the total amount of money we have to spend. So therefore, that particular issue, importance may be different from country to country. But we invited some of the countries where the risk reduction issue is very important, such as Indonesia, for example. So we share the same the political dynamics to spend more money for risk reduction against the natural disasters. So therefore, in altogether, 14 the academies get together this time. Some of them share the same concerns, particularly for some of the issues, but some others are not. So therefore, one of the direction toward the future from this G Science Academy meeting is to discuss the particular issue with not 14 all countries, but picking up some of the countries among those 14 or some other countries not included in those 14 academies.
I think in general speaking, we need huge money to improve vulnerability. But at the same time, we are supposed to utilize budget in very wise manner, right? And especially we have a foreign aid and many such international organization support. And to use budget in very effectively, wise way, we think we need a common method for metrics or exchange information. Otherwise, you cannot utilize money in very efficient manner.
Can you give us an example of a common metric that you'd like to see?
Common metric?
Well, for example, number of casualties and natural disasters, mm-hmm. and the number of the broken houses and the situation. So those are the understood commonly useful. But, it is not easy to set up the common the metrics in a case of natural disasters. As you understand that we had the UN meeting, the conference last year in Sendai, mm-hmm. and one of the topics is how to develop the common metrics to understand the scale of natural disasters. But still, discussion is going on. So we are now trying to find the suitable metrics for the natural disasters. So that issue is not easy. One of the things which are lacking is the statistics. Some of the countries, even there is no the statistics for the natural disasters. So we have to overcome those difficulties.
Okay, is there any questions? Are there other questions? If yes, please. Fujii-san.
I'm from Nagoya University. Actually, I'm a graduate student, so I'm so happy to hearing the third topic, nurturing the future scientist. And actually, I'm questioned about the third point of the third topic, the method of assessment for scientists. Yeah, actually, you mentioned about the quantitative method is not so good. But I think I also agree with a more qualitative method for evaluating scientists. Do you have any concrete idea for a method or something idea?
Okay, it is not exactly whether it is quantitative or qualitative. And for example, when we talk about research paper, what is very apparent is quantity. But also quality of each paper is also important. But the point of this message is like that. Beside paper writing, you have to do many works as a scientist. For example, you outreach your result to society, or you educate children, or you teach in university. So that is type is quite different from paper writing. So we should be more comprehensive in evaluation of career of scientists, because that is really serious problem in young scientists. Maybe you are one of the young scientists. Do you know that there are postdoc position, right? And there are many postdoc position, but that postdoc position is for a particular research area or particular purpose, that is for education or outreach to society. So when you are engaged in such project for outreaching society, writing research paper is very hard, right? And we think that is very important issue. That means society, working with society is also important. This is number four. And therefore, we have to evaluate such benefit given by such young researchers. And this kind of metrics of research topic, this idea is shared by many academies, right? Of course, metric is important in some case, okay, writing many research paper, especially when you are concentrating into particular topic, right? Work very hard and write paper is important. But at the same time, especially for future career, in addition to writing a paper, working with society or transdisciplinary work is also important. So to change our science society, we think that evaluation method should be changed. Otherwise, young people suffer from such a new idea. That is the idea behind this.
Have any other questions? Yes? No? Okay. No other questions?
May I add some?
Yes, please.
Okay, this time we invited developing country. A number is not small because G7 countries, seven, and another seven is from not all of them, mainly from developing country. And what we found is that problem is very common. Same problem happened. Same problem of such a brain disease, right? And necessity of science is common. And the future science development is common issue. And disaster depends. However, basically people, academy has a common idea. We have to reduce disaster risk by utilizing our knowledge or utilizing budget in efficient way. So basically there were not big argument, difficult argument in this topic. It's just addition.
Okay, any other questions? Okay, if there's no more questions, thank you very much for coming to the briefing. I'd like to close today's briefing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.